Joining us in the studio between Steve and myself is a wide receiver, Terry Glenn. And Terry, thanks for coming in. It's nice to see you. I think a lot of people would want to know how come you weren't in a fine uniform today as opposed to coming on TV here, but I guess you can answer that question.
Well, you know, I wish I was out there. The guys out there look like they're having a lot of fun, and I definitely would like or would like to be a part of that, but, you know, right now I got a sore hamstring.
What is the deal with the hamstring? And how, you know, when you say a sore hamstring, people say, well, the darn thing's been sore for 8 weeks. And when are, if you are, going to play here again?
You know, I can't answer that question. Only the doctors can answer that question, and it depends on how I feel from week to week. And as of last week, I didn't feel like I can go out there and play and give it 100%. And right now, I'm just trying to wait day to day. Tomorrow, I'll know more.
Chronic disorder. That was your disability. What's up with that?
Just what it says. That's what it sounds like.
A chronic depression, I should say.
Yeah, chronic depression.
Depression.
I guess that's the diagnosis that I was given. You know, I went to go see somebody, and, you know, the man told me that I was suffering from chronic depression. And I really didn't know what that was, but I knew something was wrong when I always woke up every day and kind of, you know, not happy and going over to the practice field and not feeling up, you know, to do the things that I wanted to do. And when I went to go see him, he said, you know, you're suffering from depression, and that's what it was.
You know, Terry, I think the frustrating thing is, and I'm sure, and maybe it is for you, but for the fans to say, God, this kid's got all the talent in the world. You've heard it all before. All the talent in the world. He could really help this team, especially now because they're starting to win. He could stretch the field. You could do so many things. We'd like to see him out there. You remember that first half when you were back, and for that one game when you were back, the crowd's reaction. All that other off-the-field stuff was forgotten. It was all about Terry Glenn, football player.
Well, it was forgotten by the fans, but obviously I'm the one who goes through it, so it wasn't forgotten by me. Granted, it was fun to go out there and catch passes and catch a touchdown and help win football games, but the reality of the whole matter is I still had to go home, and I'm still living with the same things that I was living with before I went out there on the football field. So for people to say, hey, you know, he needs to get out there, he needs to do that, sure, I want to get out there and do things like that, but on my end of it, I want to do it, but on the other end of it, I don't think that's what other people have, you know, in the view.
Do you want to play here? Do you want to play for the New England Patriots?
I did.
Did?
I did. D-I-D, I did.
That means pass.
It does. And as of right now, I don't see me playing here next year, and I don't see myself being in a Patriot uniform.
Now, why do you say that?
I think things have turned for the worse. You know, I've done some you know, bad things during the lifetime of, you know, of my life, and I will take responsibility and say I have done some idiotic things, and I'm trying to grow up, and I've done things that have hurt my reputation. But also, there are things that you try to get over.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it happened. Okay, let's stymie it and let's move on and try to live for the future.
But people say you don't take responsibility.
No, that's people.
For your
they, you know, they can say what they want to say. I don't live for the people. You know, I live for myself. You know, I have a son, I have a little sister, and those are two people that I really live for. And I try to take responsibility for my actions. You know, there's things that happened and they got escalated. And I say, hey, you know, it wasn't my fault. At the same time, it was my fault. I initiated what happened, but there were some things that really escalated that I had to fight and I had to battle with. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to just lay down and say, hey, I'm dead. You know, you can just go ahead and suspend me for this and do whatever you want. Things that happened wasn't my fault, and I'm going to say they weren't my fault.
Terry, where does football fit into the scheme of things for you?
You know, it's right up there. That's one of the things that really makes me happy. One of the few things in this world, and I love to do it. But right now, you know, I'm hampered by a hamstring injury, and I can't go out there and do it. So, you know, I'm not doing it.
What about your signing bonus, $11 million? Have you blown that altogether? I mean, do you ever think about that? Do you ever sit at home and say, I've just blown $11 million?
Actually, no. Because it's never been about the money to me. I can care less how much money I make. I want to play football and be happy. I want people to respect the fact that I get up every morning, I live my life the way I live my life. I've been through these things, and I have to go out there and put my front foot forward and do what I have to do. It ain't about the money. Like I said, I don't see myself being in a Patriot uniform next year. I will go to another team and make the minimum.
You know, Mo Vaughn said it wasn't about the money.
Well, this way, let me ask.
But athletes say it's not about the money.
We're just kind of running short of time. About, I just want to clear up this this perception. Perception is Terry Glenn's not playing because he's not getting paid. He's getting paid his salary, but he's not getting paid his bonus money. So it's kind of like a wildcat strike on Terry Glenn's part.
I mean, you can view it how you want to view it.
I'm asking you how what the reality
is. Every day, all the time.
Just give me the reality.
That's what you say.
Give me the reality.
That is the reality. Reality is what you make it to be. And that's what it is.
Am I wrong? Tell me I'm wrong. I can handle it.
I don't know. Are you?
You
may answer that. You may go get Ron Borges or some of those other guys over there, some of them other characters over there. Maybe they can answer for you. They'll come up with something that they can just say and get people to believe. I mean, I'm okay with that. I know I'm bothered by hamstring right now, so, and I'm not getting paid, so you do the math.
If you were getting paid, would that hamstring get better? Let me ask you that question.
I don't know. I really don't know. I can't say that. I don't know.
Do you see yourself coming back and playing this season?
I don't know. I really don't know. I hope so.
Do you?
I would love to. I would love to go out there and have fun with those guys. You know?
Don't you think obviously this hasn't, your teammates seem to support you.
And that's fine.
I mean, is this true or not?
That's fine. Yeah. I mean, I welcome it. But if they didn't, I mean, I'm not going to lose any sleep. I love the guys on that football team, and I want to go out there and work hard for those guys. But at the same time, when I leave that facility, I have to go home. Those guys don't come home with me, okay? So therefore, I live my life the way I got to live my life. Just like you got other guys like Curtis Martin and guys like that are no longer with this team, they had to move on. And they found other teammates and other guys they have to rely on, have to rely on them. What I'm saying.
What's it like watching your team play and you not being there, like today, like a big win at home today?
You know, I get nervous just like I do when I'm out there playing. I'd rather be out there with those guys and trying to help them win. But like I said, there's more to it than just going out there playing with those guys and trying to help them win. You know, I'm happy for Tom Brady.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm real happy for Tom Brady.
You see any issues with Bledsoe? And you've been around more than most with Bledsoe, so.
Do I see any issues?
Yeah, with him.
Brady or Bledsoe? Obviously, Brady. He's helped the team win thus far. And the performance tonight just really shows what kind of guy Brady is. Regardless if he go out here next week and fall flat on his face or not, this guy has really dealt through a lot of media criticism, and a lot of people have said he probably can't do it and he's going to fall on his face, but he's showing you.
What about the coach? What about the coach, Terry? Do you feel betrayed by him? Do you feel betrayed by the owner?
Not at all. Not at all. I felt that these
by either one?
Not at all.
Okay.
These people did what they had to do under the circumstances. And I say, if you're going to continue to allow this to go on, then let me go. That's all I can say. If we're going to end this and move on and go to the future, then let's do that. But why continue to escalate something that has already happened? There's nothing we can do about that. All we can do is put an end to it and try to move on to the future if you want me here. If you don't, then dispose of me or do whatever you can with me to get me out of this uniform.
Who has to give first? Who has to give in first? You or the Patriots?
I've already gave in. You see me came here. I came here San Diego week, prepared, ready to go, giving it my all. And that's what I did. The other side didn't give anything, didn't budge whatsoever. And you know,
so you don't think the Patriots have cut you any slack whatsoever? You don't think the Patriots have been patient with you that you are even still on this football team?
Look, I don't care if I'm still on this football team. I love to play football, okay?
Mm-hmm.
People get paid to play. People get paid to do their job. And that's what I want to happen. I want to go out and play, and I want to get paid. It's not about cutting me slack. All right, I go out here, I help this team win football games, I give it my all. You can't never say I give it my all. I give it my all. I played every snap the last 2 years, haven't been hurt. So therefore, you know, the Patriots have done a lot for me, and I can't say they haven't.
I got to take a break, Steve, and I'm going to analyze this game. So you help us analyze this game. I mean, did you have a chance to move in the analyst booth now?
Hey, I do whatever, you know, whatever it takes.